Hey there, fellow musicians. I bet you've been waiting for a new tutorial, and it wasn't really a request as it was more interest on my side. Someone Like You by Adele, a lot of tutorials about the chord inversion, which this is not. If you see this, I guess you came across my piece that I posted as separate video. I suggest you keep that open as a tab. Open the tutorial in the second tab, and then you can switch back and forth and see how the piece should sound like. I didn't play it 100% flawlessly, but it is a very hard piece. When you learn it yourself, make sure you have a lot of patience. It took me over 30 hours to get to where I am with it. Mind you, most of the time went into actually making the piece complete based on that tutorial. You can check the link out again by yourself and see how much there is or how little. Yeah, a lot of work went into it, trying to figure out what is what and where goes, what goes where. No notes, no nothing. I don't have notes for you guys either. I'll see if I can compose it or not, but I know it will take me hours to do that, so better be patient on that. All I can offer you right now is the tutorial the way it is. And so, again, be patient, have fun, check back anytime. I hope you enjoy, and please, appreciate the hours that went into it, and if you have any suggestions, improvements, then please go right ahead. But remember, I'm a one-year piano noob, so go easy on me. Thanks. Okay, we have the beginning, I guess, that we should start at. We play four times the stack of three notes. Slowing down at the end is kind of neat because it makes people listen up a little bit, especially when you vary in the loudness. The quieter you play, the more the people will listen up. When you go real loud, people will, you know, act quite differently again. So also use your pedal because that will make a big difference. Listen to this. Exactly, so, and I already put some extra release in here, so normally it would sound like this. Right? With the pedal. Without the pedal. So, pedal, very important. If you can add release on your digital piano, do that. The whole piece just sounds great. Especially in those repetitive parts, the more interesting you can make those, the best. Because there's a lot of shit tutorials that go only about those chords, and that's bullshit. So anyway, moving on. We add the left hand, and the left hand will play this. Already sounds nice. All together. Excessively, but and then the next part is gonna be the left hand will take over what the right hand played with one change, where the right hand plays at the end this, the left hand will play a very low D instead of that F. Okay, so everything is the same except that. This will come in handy later on. So learn this very good. So we play. Okay. And then the right hand will play. Thank you. sounds like this. Left hand plays one time. The second time we start with the right hand. Change to tricky. It is absolutely vital that you can play this right, because that gets more complicated later on. Okay, this is how we play it. And then we move down from a G sharp to an A. And then instead of playing an E here, we play the D. Together, slow, I hope. We repeat this. And here it becomes critical to how you repeat the left hand, because this sounds boring. Sounds better and either you repeat all three keys or just the top two. For me it depends on how harsh I want to play it, I guess. So from here we go up and play the chorus, or whatever you would call that. Without hitting two keys at the same time would be nice. You have to play that E again and then move right up to F and the or F sharp and C sharp. Right? And then we want to repeat our A. Now for this part, you can do at least two or three variations, because you can play. You notice there was a little break, a little pause. You can play. Or towards the end, you can play. Not that easy. Okay. But anyway, you can listen to the piece and then roll it in, but maybe I should just repeat that. A change when we play. Because before we played, now we play. Sounds like this. When we go down to this A, we want to play F sharp. When we go the next step, we want to play G sharp. Sounds like this. And then we slide down to A and we repeat D. Let's just do this in the motion. And here comes something new again. Because we play, that is my variation. I came up with that. I'm proud of it, so that's what I'm saying. I did. At least I haven't heard it before like this. So, because the guy plays it quite a bit different, but then he also plays. So, if this one is too tricky for you, then just stick with. And altogether would sound like this. Should probably show without hitting the wrong keys. Tricky, so the other version not that tricky. Timing is everything. Piece. It's not really a tutorial, but I played that one by ear. It just sounded nice, so it was fairly easy to make it out. So I use that because it's again a different playing. So if you looked at all the other tutorials, it plays simply the chords according to the piece that you have to sing to it to make it sound good. Well, maybe this playing all these variations will help you.